So just to recap everything that we've done so far, we first started out with a rule of thumb that they use. Why did they use a rule of thumb? Why didn't they just use this? This is Newton's law of cooling. Newton was around in the 1700s. And it's obviously a better model, right? Why are they using this? Why do you think they're using the 1.5 rule? And this is giving you really different answers. One is giving you 20 hours, the other one's giving you 10 hours. That's a huge difference. So why would they use the 1.5 rule? There's no doubt. Do you have no doubt in your mind the 1.5 rule is probably oversimplified?
Yeah.
Right? We drew it, right? It didn't make any sense after some time. So why do you think someone would use something like that? Any ideas?
Better.
Hmm?
There's no better idea.
Well, Newton was around since 1700s. Surely since the 70s, I mean, it's taught in pre-calc, so surely medical doctors would know this, forensic scientists would know this. Why would they not use it?
Wouldn't it need to change? Didn't like some number change for like every...
I mean, we could use this as our model. We fit it to some data. You don't have to take this data. You could take all the data that I have in that paper, average it, and then get an average model for all the coefficients, right? You say, what's the average room temperature? What was the average baseline temperature at time of death? And then you could fit the model. So you could do it once, and then you'd have one model that would work. Any other ideas of why they might use a 1.5 rule as opposed to this one? Let's think about the number of questions you asked me about 1.5 rule when we were doing it. How many questions were there? Everybody just started, right? How many questions were there for here? Hands are shooting up. You know, what's the E thing? You know, what's, you know, where's my calculator? I don't know where this. Tons of questions, right? Is this harder than the other one? Yes, that's the reason. So when you have something that's really easy like that, that's why people use it. And that's why it's not changed. That's why it's not changed over. And constant rules like that, they stick. They stick really hard. In medicine, there's so many of them. Because while you're diagnosing a patient, you need to do it quickly. So people rely on constant rules all the time. And you can find them all over the place. We're actually, I think something's appearing in JAMA soon on a constant rule that's used in weight loss. It's on the Surgeon General's website. It's on the CDC website. But it's highly inaccurate. But this is what we're using to guide people's weight loss across the nation or give guidance for public health. So the reason is it's easy. That's why people use it, and that's why they prefer to use it. So let's actually do the calculation algebraically now. You came with around 20 to 22. Now I'm going to show you step by step how to find the exact answer, not using... You can do this perfectly fine. In the real world, you probably would, right? You'd say, let me back calculate using logs. Probably wouldn't do that.
Well, you would do it. You would back calculate.